So now we will see controlling electrical switches with ASPNET Core Web API, C# WinForms and ESP32 IoT. This is a purely web API project. This is a desktop application and this is a remote device. This application is used to control electrical switches on this device. This can be used for street lighting or for other similar projects also. But the only condition is that all three of them, they should be on the same Wi-Fi network. This is the only condition which can be achieved in a small laboratory. For testing purposes, you can see it working also. And this C# Win application communicates with this Web API project through JWT authentication. And this application, it talks to the ESP32 device. The state of the switches is stored in a database contained in this ASPNET Core Web API project. I will show you all three of them working together. So first of all, let me take up this Web API project. As you can see, this project contains a program.cs file. This file contains all the Web API of this project. And these are all get, put and all. And this is a basic auth handler. This is for JWT authentication. These are a few model classes. And this folder contains our data. So this is all about this simple ASPNET Core project. And on this side, we have a device that is connected to an electrical plug. This device is already programmed to connect to the Wi-Fi. And on this, there are four LEDs you see. This LED is a status LED. Whenever the project is connected to, whenever this device is connected to this ASPNET Core project, this will start blinking. And these are the three switches which will be controlled through and desktop application that I will come shortly. And let me start debugging this one so that we can see that a communication is established. And as you can see, as soon as this device comes in contact with this ASPNET Core application, this LED has started blinking. So now it is time for me to also start the C# application so that I can control the state. This is the C# application that I have opened, the Solution Explorer. This contains a user control for a switch, and let me move it to one side as this designer loads, and let it load, and in the meantime I can open the form also so that you can have a look at how it will ultimately look. So this is the form, and that is I'll move it a bit sideways. So this is how it will look actually. And now I will run this also. But before that, I would like to fold it a bit so that all three of them, they come in one line. So I'll just bring all of them in one line. And so if all of them are now in one line, I will now start this project. Let the window open, and here it says a login box is shown. I'll have to find a space so that this is the login box produced by the C# desktop application. Click on login, and as soon as it logs in, it displays the states of the switches. I'll try to bring it in view. So it should be sufficient now. So now it says all the states are off, and I can click on turn on. As soon as I click on turn on, the status is altered here, and this button, this bulb continues to starts glowing. Click on this one, and this one starts glowing. Click on this one, and the middle one starts glowing. So this is basically now being controlled through a client application that runs on the same Wi-Fi network, and this is the whole project. The source code of all the modules and complete explanation has been given, so you can check it and make use of this project. I'll close it right now. Thank you.